And just down below the video, if you click like, that'll make sure that YouTube shows this video to more people. Thanks. Need Excel tips, don't you? Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2654. What are these SEC Edgar numbers all text in Excel? Hey, we're going to take a sort of break from Copilot today to talk about this problem. But first, my apologies to the folks out there who are left-handed and hold their coffee mugs in the other hand, and you want to have that message showing to your coworkers. We now have left-handed or right-handed coffee mugs so the message can be out. Okay, yesterday's video, 2652, financial analysis using Copilot in Excel. Mind-blowing. It was absolutely amazing. Again, thanks to Dr. Nitin and his channel for that. You know, but we're in this strange period in history where Copilot and other LLMs can solve things really quickly. They're growing by leaps and bounds. But if you're in a situation where the numbers actually matter, you need to go back and verify that Copilot is correct, which really, if you think about it, causes you to go to Copilot, get the answers, and then go verify all the answers. It takes longer than just performing the analysis yourself. Now, that'll change. It'll get to the point where we can trust this, but right now, we're not at the point where we can trust it. So yesterday, here was the financial statement. Here's the answers that I got from Copilot. I copy these from Copilot, paste them into a text box here, and I'm going to go through and verify all of these before I post the video to make sure that it's actually working. So current ratio, we need current assets divided by current liabilities. So simple enough, point to current assets, point to current liabilities. And I should have already known I was in trouble because they're left justified. What the heck is up with that? And sure enough, when I divide this by that, I get a value error. What the heck? So equal is number. And click on that cell, and it is not numeric. Let's check all of these, none of these. And here's how you can tell, because I selected a whole bunch of things that clearly should be numbers, and down here in the status bar, it's saying count 34. It's not telling me the numeric count, it's not telling me the total, it's not telling me the average. Clearly something is wrong. You know, and then I start to wonder, okay, I copied this data from SEC Edgar database, I pasted it to Excel, and I mentioned yesterday I had to clean up some merge cells and things like that. You know, but like, what is it? Is it the comma? Are the commas causing the problem? So what's the length? Let's see what the length is. So we have number 12,363, and the length comes back as 7. And you and I think 12,363, that should be 6, right? So there's something extra there. So my usual strategy here is we're just gonna come in and say equal mid of that number, 12,363, and I want the mid starting at all 7 numbers. So the sequence of 7 for a length of 1, enter, that's going to give me 7 answers. So I'm getting 12,363. And again, at this point, I still think it's the comma is a weird comma. So what I'm going to do is ask for equal code. Get me the ASCII code for all the numbers, and that hash sign there is the array formula operator. And so I get a 49, which is a 1. That checks out 50. And then I have to admit, I actually don't know. If I just type a comma here, what should the code be for a comma? 44, okay, so that's right, 51. God darn it, it's a character 160. This is a non-breaking space. This has been a problem ever since the web became a thing. If people need space, space, space to appear in a website, they're not putting spaces in there, they're putting character 160s, the ampersand NBSP semicolon, because the browser won't eliminate 3 non-breaking spaces. It'll leave them there, and maybe things will be lined up a little bit. Oh, it drives me crazy. And what the thing that really drives me crazy is we have a function called clean in Excel that's supposed to get rid of all the garbage, but clean will not clean the character 160. It's just so freaking annoying that this has been annoying us for so long. How hard could it be for the Excel team, for the calc team, to fix clean so that way it actually gets rid of the one thing that we need it to clean? Just horribly frustrating. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. I'm going to select all of these cells that should be numeric here and go into Find and Replace, Control H. And what I need to type up here in the Find What is a character 160 space. And unfortunately, that's not on our keyboard. So here's one way to do that. I'm gonna hold down the Alt key on my keyboard, and type 0160, release alt. All right, now it's frustrating. It's a space, you can't see it, but you can see the insertion point moved over when I finish that. So hold down alt while I'm holding down alt, 0160, and then let go of alt, and it inserts a character 160. And I want to replace that with nothing. So I leave that blank, replace all. All done, we made 74 replacements. Okay, all right, so yay, we now have numbers down here. But let's think about what happened in yesterday's video. That means that I sent Copilot a whole bunch of text, and they're starting to do math on the text, and it worked. And then I have this horrible feeling. What if the only reason that it worked is because it was text? What happens when we send numbers to Copilot? Like, does that break it, making yesterday's video completely wrong? Now let's fix these others here, the other two sections. You know, that's my panic. Okay, so I'm gonna save this with a new name. That new name being Coca-Cola Financial Statements Numbers. And then I ran the exact same questions that I ran yesterday, and it came up with the exact same answers. A weird bug here where they're showing me the formatting codes instead of the actual numbers, but if you go through there, they're actually there. This bug was there last week. It was fixed on the weekend when I recorded the video for yesterday, and now it's back. So, you know, this is all stuff in preview, and I get it. Things are going to break and then not break. So the message for today, if you're copying numbers from SEC Edgar and those numbers are showing up as text in Excel, it's very likely that it's a character 160. Remember that awesome trick. Hold down Alt and then type 0160, let go of Alt, and that allows you to type a non-breaking space in the Find and Replace box so that we can convert those non-breaking spaces to nothing and get numbers back and continue your analysis. Crazy. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Hey, just below the video, click the store icon. We have a whole bunch of new mugs and shirts, professionally designed, all kinds of great, fun slogans for you or your favorite Exceler. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.